It's hard to believe that this was once the home for an entire community. For 5 years, the people of Argyle Street attempted to follow alternative ideals and create a unique way of life. The residents, dissatisfied with today's society, were soon branded as outcasts and anarchists. Many believed society had rejected them, but indeed, Argyle Street had rejected society.
Argyle Street started about 5 years ago with when the first squatters moved in. At that time it was a street with a lot of empty houses in it and some so-called problem families who the council only gives short-term housing to. Squatters moved into a few houses and pretty soon the whole street was occupied. Then some of the squatters organised a housing cooperative, got it registered and negotiated with the council. Through a bit of pressure on the council, who were very unwilling at first, negotiated a licence to stay here. The co-op then went on to apply for £1 million grant from the sort of official government body, Society for Cooperative Dwellings. And we were all set to receive this money until Michael Heseltine, the Department of the Environment, stepped in and said no. Government intervened.
When was this? How long ago was this then?
This was about 2.5 years ago.
Yeah.
At that point, the council immediately said, OK, you're not getting the money, we're not going to offer any compromise to you at all. And they just like that said, license agreement out, we want you out. Yeah. This meant, in effect, that the street was no longer recognised. And it took 2 years for the council to get it together to issue proper eviction notices.
Yeah.
Last autumn, they actually began their legal proceedings against us, last September. It's been a fight since then.
Yeah.
We've gone through the courts, but the law is fixed on the size of those of property. The whole population of the street's been really fluid, all sorts of different people moving in and out. And until now, we've known since January that they have the legal right to the houses.
Yeah.
And people have considered moving on together.
Yeah.
And what's happening now, I think, is a sort of an exodus from the street.
Yeah.
But the saying is they can knock it down, but they can't take it away. Everyone learns from the street, it's a street of experience. There needs to be more like it. There's a time for this street to go, to move on. It's a creative place. It's a place where people have produced things, where people have learnt a lot, where people don't hide their affection and their aggression, right?
Media coverage increased dramatically in the weeks building up to the eviction. 10 days before, an incident at the ferryboat public house provoked headlines which led to a public outcry. The police felt they could no longer stand by in the face of such media pressure. On February the 13th, 60 police officers raided Argyle Street, armed with search warrants for all 147 houses. The press were quick to pick up on a photograph of a single police officer removing two air rifles and a crossbow.
I don't judge by looks, and I don't go by what other people say about other people. A one percenter. FTW, and it doesn't mean feed the world, it means free the weed. People down here are great. All right, I've taken drugs, fair enough, you know. But anybody who takes needles, I mean, out of the street, man. Right, we have a bit of blow. I mean, it grows out the ground. Whose fault is it? You can't blame us, can you? We ain't doing no harm to people down here. You know, if people upset us, we'll upset them back. Just one little family. That's all we want. Take away a home. For what?
What are you going to build instead? A car park or something?
They're not really your home, are they? Your squad. Yeah, only because the council wouldn't take rent. That wasn't until they'd actually turned over the court order to get us out that they terminated this co-op thing. They've knocked on my door and said, pay me so much per week rent. I'd have paid her.
Yeah. So what is the purpose tonight? To burn down and knock down the houses?
Well, it's no purpose at all, you know. We're just having our last night in our homes and then we're going to wander off. Sad night.
Where are you going to wander off to?
Who knows? We asked the council for somewhere to park vehicles, they wouldn't even give us that.
Everybody's gone, what, half a dozen of us left, a dozen or so?
We'll still be here till the end.
Well, I will be anyway.
We've dismantled the street ourselves to quite an extent. There's no point in leaving it here for the sort of the destroyers.
Yeah.
Decided to make the most out of it ourselves. Some people, you know, we've been selling the tiles or parts of the houses, taking them for ourselves. I've got a bus, which I sort of converted down here, using materials from the street, recycling. Other people have smashed off a few houses to let off their energy.
Few here tonight have come down, people who've lived here previously, who've come down to say their last goodbye. But I mean, actually living here, I think there are about a dozen people left.
There's an awful lot of media down here. There's probably about as many media people as there are residents. How do you feel about that kind of attention?
I don't know. I mean, I find it very strange, actually. It's sort of odd being, you know, this sort of focus of attention all of a sudden, you know. I mean, in some ways it's quite exhilarating. And in other ways, it's very weird. I mean, it's a mixture.
Do you find it amusing? I mean, there's one chap down here, all the way from London, BBC Radio 4, looking for a story. Doesn't think he'll go back to anything, and the national papers will be here tomorrow morning.
No, I think they'll go back with something. I think they'll go back with something, but perhaps not what they expected.
Ah. So, what's going to happen then?
Wait and see.
He laughs at the green. He laughs at everybody when he falls in the street. He never can stop laughing. He says he never cried. But first he did arrest the man and laugh until he cried. Ha 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 his face is wrinkled, and then he shut his eyes. He opened his great mouth, big bottle front for size. He said, I must arrest you, he didn't know what for. And then he started laughing, and then he grabbed his
an elderly gentleman in here.
And I'll see him before
this.
At the end of the street's a high-rise tower block, and that's how they want us to live. But this place is about doing it yourself.
Tom Jacks, who had a terraced house in Argyle Street, shared this disused warehouse in a Norwich back street with 15 other former residents as part of Norwich City Council's rehousing programme. However, due to an incident involving non-residents, they were evicted once again. The sadness evoked by the eviction turned to bitterness and resentment. Those who rejected the council scheme decided to leave Norwich and head for the North Norfolk coast. Here at C. Pauling, a collection of brightly painted buses arrived and set up camp, intending to join the festival circuit this summer.
You can be a civilian, but you don't have to change for any external reasons that would lead you to stray. Don't you believe in a fashion show? Are you with no commitments, no passion, you could be counting the cars. When you're looking at me, I can see it's sometimes so hard to get free. Hard to get free, free, free. Hard to get free, free. Try to say it don't suit ya. It's only heroin hope that's turned your back to the future. Hey, when you're in love, there's no reason to worry. When you're in love, never say sorry.